WhatsApp video is Sofan from TechCycle. UI announced its owner meet-time today, that is on November 28th. If you think this video is late, it is because of editing time. So let us begin the exploration of UI owner meet-time. UI owner meet-time is the sibling of UI meet-time with a some features less, but it includes the headphone jack, which is omitted in UI Mate 10 and at a lower price. Talking about the spec of this UI Honor V10, it got a 5.99-inch IPS LCD screen with a 1080p resolution and an aspect ratio of 18:9. It is powered by Kirin 970 chipset, which is 10 nanometer, which is processed under 10 nanometer. And got i7 core processor. It also got dedicated neural processing unit and it runs on Android Oreo. About camera, it got 60 megapixel primary camera and 20 megapixel secondary camera, which is monochrome sensor or which is shooting black and white. This camera is integrated with AI, which offers real-time scene recognition and object recognition. And the front camera is of 30 megapixel. It also got AI, which offers self-portrait, and this camera offers face unlock, which with an unlock time of 400 millisecond. It also got fingerprint sensor, and it is packed with a 3750 milliampere battery with fast charging. And about the special feature of this UI Honor V10, it got Animoji, which is far better than Apple's. That is what UI is stating. I have not seen it, but in their showcase, they shown that when the user stick their tongue out, the Animoji will also stick their tongue out, which is great compared to Apple's, because Apple's Animoji does not stick their tongue out. If you want to know more about this Animoji thing and the face unlock and the sensor they use in their UI Honor V10, you can check the link in the description. It is iPhone X. It got every sensor detail and everything. Just click the link down in the description. You can find all the details regarding the face unlock and the sensor they are using in their UI Honor V10. Moving on, based on color, they come in 4 variants: black, aurora blue, gold, and red. Based on the storage option, they comes with 3 variants, that is 4 gigs RAM and 64 gigs internal storage, which is come under $409, 6 gigs RAM and 64 gigs storage, which comes under $455, and 6 gigs RAM and 128 gigs internal storage, which comes for about $530. That's all about this device, that is UI Honor V10. And the question comes, does this device worth the money we are going to spend? Looking at the specs and everything, I will not spend my money for this device, because the high-end UI Honor V10 comes for about $530, but you can purchase OnePlus 5T, high-end OnePlus 5T for $549, $19 high, and it is a great device, because UI Honor V10 comes with 6 gigs of RAM and Kirin 970 processor, but OnePlus 5T comes with 8 gigs of RAM and Snapdragon 835 processor, which is a very good processor and it is developer friendly. Also, OnePlus 5T is 1 millimeter shorter and it got a 6 inch screen. Also, it is about 10 gram less than that of UI Honor V10, which is 172 gram. Also, OnePlus 5T got AMOLED screen, while this UI Honor V10 just got IPS LCD screen only. In UI Honor V10, we get a microSD card expansion, but it comes under a cost, that is you cannot use dual SIM and an SD card, because it got an hybrid SIM slot only. If you want to use both dual SIM and this microSD card, you need to use the hybrid SIM adapter, which will protrude out of your device. If you want to know more about hybrid SIM slot, you can check the video over there. On camera, on my previous experience, I found that UI device will come with a great camera for taking photos, but this device will not be great for taking videos because it does not support OIS and EIS, while the OnePlus 5T got EIS support. But this Y on our V10 got this AI integrated, and it will be great for taking photos only. And looking at the front, from the spec itself, we can find that OnePlus 5T wins by 3 megapixel and an EIS stabilization. If you are an Animoji person, you like Animoji and playing with Animoji, this will be your device because it got Animoji which is greater than Apple's Animoji. Also, it got a greater battery capacity. It got about 3750 milliampere battery, which is very high compared to 3300 milliampere on OnePlus 5T. So the time to take the decision arrives. In my case, I will buy OnePlus 5T only because it got 8 gigs of RAM, Snapdragon 835 processor, better camera and a better developer support. If you are a person who like to play with the Animoji, you need fingerprint at the front, we need a bigger battery, we need the micro SD card expansion, and we need the sensors which need to work for face unlock rather than the front camera which uses in OnePlus 5T, Y Honor V10 will be your device. It will go on a sale on December 5th on China. The same day it will be released on London. And thanks for watching, guys. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you think this video sucks, hit the dislike button. Let me know so I can improve my comments. And if you got suggestion for another videos like this or anything else, just comment down below. Or you can do that on Twitter, Facebook or Google+. Link will be in the description. And don't forget to subscribe for more videos like these.